Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Code with Vivek. If you want to see my upcoming new tutorials, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 10th episode about few basics. In the previous episode, we worked on events, and today we'll work on form and handle two-way binding using free model directive. First of all, open your text editor, and to work on the form, we're gonna use this product review component which we had created in our previous session. Now let's remove this h1 tag and instead let's add the HTML form, which consists of name, review, rating and a submit button. Then at the bottom we can add the data for name, review and rating. Now we will use free module to bind our data into this input. So over here I'm gonna write free module name. For text area I'm gonna write free module and review, and for select I'm gonna write free module and rating. Let's also add a modifier number so that it can typecast this value as a number. Check the site now, and we can see the form, but it is displaying as a full width. It is not displaying inside the container. So you can open our product component. You can cut this product review and paste them inside container. Check the site again, and this time the form is looking great. Now let's also test whether our form is working or not. So open your developer tool, click on view, open your product review component, and now you can add some name. You can see the name is working. Let's add some review. I'll just add test. It is working as well. And finally, the rating is working. Now let's add click event on this submit button. So open your product review component, and where it says form, you can add submit, which will pass a method called onSubmit. We will add this method after some time, but before that, let's add the modifier called prevent. This will help to prevent a default behavior, or in other words, the page won't refresh when we click on the submit button. Now let's add onSubmit method. Here I will add a variable which contains the object, and over here I'm gonna add name, which will return from our data. So it will be this.name. For review, it gonna be this.review, and for rating, it gonna be this.rating. Below this, I'm gonna add this.name equals null, this.review equals null, this.rating equals null. I have added this so that the form get reset when we submit the form. Also now, when we click the submit button on our form, it will create this product review object, but we haven't sent it anywhere. Since it's a product review, it would be great to show them under our product component, which is our parent. As we learned in the previous session, we can send the custom event using this.$emit. We call the event review submitted, and the value we passed is called product review. Now open your parent component, which is product.view, and in this product review you can add add review submitted, and you can add a method. I will call add review. Then on the method, you can add review. We are passing product review, and then here we can write this dot reviews dot push product review. We don't have reviews in our data yet, so here you can add reviews and add empty array. So at the moment, whenever we submit the review form, the information gets stored in this reviews data. To show this information in the template, we can scroll to the top. I will just paste my template, which is div class reviews. It has got s2 and p tag. To show the reviews, I'm gonna add ul li. I'm gonna add b4 and say review in reviews. I need the key, it will be index. So I'm gonna modify this code into review and index. Then inside this p tag, I want to show review.review, and inside this span tag, I want to show review.name. Also in the same span tag, I'm gonna add the strong. I will add the title called rating, and for rating I'm gonna add review.rating. Now check your site and fill up this form. If you click the submit button, we can see our review over here. Great. But we are still seeing this message. We have to show this message only if there are no review. So in this p tag, you can use vif and say not reviews.length. It is working. Now if there is no review, then the message is back. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we will validate the form. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.